In the Fly Lab, working with flies.
Hola! Hi! I'm Marta, and I'm the research technician from the Hidalgo Lab. These are the bottles that we normally have the flies on, so you can see that I have here some flies flying around, and some larvae, some pupae, and here is the fly food, so they feed on this, and then we keep them here, so that they are ready for when we need to do our crosses. And then when we need to do crosses and we need to select flies, we have to put them in the pad. This pad is connected to CO2 and it makes them fall asleep so that we can actually sort them, like separate the males from the females and the virgins. The male normally is slightly smaller than the female, and it has a dark abdomen, and if you look to the tip of the abdomen, it has like a plate that is the genitalia, while the female doesn't have this and is slightly bigger in size. And then when I want to separate the females from virgins, from non-virgins, what I do is just checking the abdomen. Normally the virgins have a very like puffy and white abdomen, and they normally have a greenish dark dot on their abdomen that is the meconium, that is basically the last meal that they have before they go into the pupae. When we have to cross a female with a male, we need to know that that female didn't mate with any other male before that, so we need to have the virgins to cross with a specific male with a specific genotype that we want. So in that way, knowing the genotype of the female and knowing the genotype of the male, then we can know exactly what's the genotype of the progeny. So that's really important because it's the first step of all the genetics protocol. So if we don't know, if we can't track the genotype, that's it. We can't actually do the genetics properly.